we're doing something a little different. Doing an Adlib tracker, too. Yes. We're gonna make some rants. And, I can't record the dot specs on you, so I'm gonna demonstrate, like, the actual sound from this. It's, like, running into the computer, so. If I had sound, we don't hear the left channel. I think the one that we make in this video would actually sound a little better. Something like this. Demonstrate first. That's the instrument editor, hit control I. Enter. Name. Tab. Get over. To the mouse. To the editor here. Turn the attack all the way up. Both the modulator and the carrier. Carrier to be shorter than the modulator in the release. About one. And we're going to use sine waves. The modulator is going to be the highest multiple wave from the slot. Carrier, three octaves above, and we use like octave six on the keyboard. It is already selected. Turn the feedback all the way up. So. Some dust bags. Make it on the computer real quick. So, there you go. So, we're gonna take it a little further. So, this is kind of like closed-ish. If I open the release up a little more. Oops, what the hell did I do? That's like 7, that's like 6. Sorry, that took so long. There we go. I can open the hi-hat. Amazing. So. You want to like do the open and close hi-hats in your sequencer. There's an effect. Z effect. It affects the release. Z5 is modulator release. Z9 is carrier release. Remember, the modulator should be longer and lower value. Turn 0 to F. It should look something like this. Close it up right here. And I'll push this in to my computer. Hopefully it won't take forever. You'll see what that variation sounds like. Sometimes it'll sound like this. You can always just change that over. This is only one hi-hat you can make. There's other waveforms. You can alias more, less, or nuts. There's four operators. You know? Anyway, I hope this hasn't been too boring. Maybe I'll make one of a snare drum or something. Let's go on.